release, this famed folk duo adds more fine songs to their already extensive catalog. Here to perform off their new CD, All That We Let In, the Indigo Girls.
Get to be a ripple in the water. We get to be a rock that's thrown. We get to be the boy on the bridge, standing over the reservoir. See the water lap along the shoreline, the buried forest of a man-made lake. Cemeteries are laying underneath it, your heart like a dam when it breaks. I'm okay, I don't have to do the killing or know what the killing is for. Isolation and the miracle of daybreak doesn't move you anymore. Connect the points and see the constellations as the night comes down on the reservoir. Again. Again. Right, then at least there will be no regret.
Emily Saliers, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
The Indigo Girls, the new CD, All That We Let In. First of all, tell me about the band. This is the same band you've been touring with for a while, yes?
Yeah.
Yeah, we saw, Claire, who plays bass, and Carol, who plays keyboards, we saw them playing with Sinead many years ago, Sinead O'Connor. And we're like, those guys are great. So we sort of lifted them in a way. And then Brady was playing with Emmylou Harris, and we just loved them and the way they played, and we put them together. They were the band for our last record as well, and for this most recent one.
The lyrics are weighty and important sometimes, fun as well, but it's been written that a little more buoyant, a little more happier than previous albums. How do you describe it?
Oh, I mean, there's definitely some more poppy kind of stuff on this record, you know, but sometimes we have like kind of weighty lyrics with a poppy song, you know, so it's, I think it does, the record feels more buoyant and kind of head bopping and stuff, and there's definitely some songs on there where there's, you know, it's uplifting, but we always try to have a little bit of uplifting, you know, stuff going on there.
I noticed that half the songs, almost half the songs are by you, Amy, the other half by Emily, and your names are credited alone. No Lennon-McCartney thing happening
no,
here.
No, no.
Is that truly the way it works? You write on your own, you completely craft all the lyrics, and then you put it on the band, and the same thing for you?
Mm-hmm.
Yep, that's
mm-hmm.
the way it works. It's always worked best for us that way, and that's that artistic and creative space and isolation from each other is a very good thing. What we do together is arrange the songs. So once I've written my songs and Amy's written hers and it's time to look to the next project, we get together and talk about the vocal harmonies, maybe which instrument we're going to choose, look at the sections of the songs, work them all together, and that's where the songs become Indigo Girls songs. But they start penned by either Amy or me.
You've been doing rhythm for the longest time, doing a little more solos now, right?
A couple more.
What is that about?
Very simple. I don't know. You know, I'm trying to become better at what I do, and so I try to have little steps. It's relative to myself, you know, and sometimes I hear something, you know, that I can't really describe to anyone else how to play, and so I just have to sit down and figure it out or something, but it's just me wanting to rock out a little bit, you know, but Emily's really she's the soloist.
And all things strings? It's like, if it's got strings, you'd like to play it? Is that basically
it? I do like stringed instruments, yeah. Yeah, I really do. I like them all.
Mandolin, new on this CD for the first time for you?
Well, Amy's been playing mandolin, and it just came up in a song for me to play mandolin on this particular record, so, and I enjoy it a lot.
Tell me about Perfect World. What do you want us to know about that song?
Oh, gosh, it's hard to, it's sort of like this, what's sort of lurking underneath the surface of all of our actions, you know, in a way, and it's like this, you know, this idea of being, we can be content at one point and another point be thinking about what effect our contentness is having on things, I guess. And it's supposed to be happy, though, too, you know. It's supposed to be a really, you know, a very fragile balance within that song of what's going on between happy and sad.
I'm afraid our time here is really short. I want to ask you, when you go to the Indigo Girls website, you go to the bottom, there's a link to a gay marriages issue-oriented website. What do you want us to know about that? Do you think this issue is going to stick around for a while?
I think it is going to stick around for a while. I'm really happy that it's come to the forefront of the political scene right now. It's a very important issue. It's a civil rights issue. Gay people should have the right to marry and enjoy all the other rights that straight people do in society. And the reason why we have the link on the website is we wanted to provide information for our fans or for whoever's interested. Maybe they can go and check out what's happening in their state or on a local level. or also find out what's happening nationally. So not just to find out what's going on in your own neighborhood, but to become sort of part of the whole national grassroots movement, because I think that's what it's going to take to win these battles. So it was important for us to disseminate that information as quickly as possible.
And we'll give the website at the end here.
That's
Amy,
great.
Emily, Indigo Girls, all that we let in. Thank you so much
for
being
here.
Thank
you so much. Appreciate
Thank you so much
it.
For
Thanks.
Playing for us.
Appreciate it.
The Indigo Girls' new CD, All That We Let In, is in stores now. For more information, go to indigogirls.com.
It's been 5 years saying you come my way. It's a little more weight than a heart can take. Heaven now that I know it's just a fantasy. I feel a hard time coming around for me. In case.